Thank you. bad tonight, Mother. Do you not want to go to England?
No, Marie. I really dread this tour. It will mean 3 months away from your father. Even though I am not allowed to see him, I like to be near enough to go to him, should he need me.
Is Papa getting better?
The doctors give us little hope of his recovery, Marie. His mind is still greatly disturbed. He sees no one, except our good friends, Brahms and Joachim. But you must not worry about this, dear child. Johannes will stay with you while I am away, and he will help Bertha to look after you, I know.
We have a surprise for you tonight, Mother.
Oh, have you?
I will be back in a minute.
Bertha, will you please pack the things I put out in my room? And put all my evening gowns in one portmanteau, please. I shall be giving many concerts while in England, and so I want everything to be handy.
Oh, before I forget, ma'am, what will your address in England be?
I shall leave it with you, Bertha. Never fear, for I shall be hoping to hear from home very often. Well, little girls, what are you up to now? Well, if you have a secret, I have one too. When Uncle Brahms comes tonight, let us surprise him by having a little soiree.
May we play our duet, Mama?
Why, yes, and you, Julie, must sing. I have it written down here. We'll sing, and you will play your duet. Bertha, will you please get that? Mary, will you please get that? Bertha is busy.
We have a present for you, Mama.
Why, thank you. Oh, how lovely.
Let me put it in, please. Oh, isn't that pretty?
Oh, yes.
Thank you very much. Good evening, Johannes.
Good evening, madam. I hope I'm in good time. You'll see I've come to stay.
Yes, and how grateful I am that you can come, Johannes. Please be seated.
You see, madame, this is my second home now. Do you remember when you first asked me to come to dine with you and Herr Schumann? I felt so shy, I dared not enter.
Yes, indeed I do. I walked the town from one end to the other in search of you. I finally found you at an inn and brought you here, remember? My husband called you the young eagle that has flown to us from across the Alps. But Johannes, can you give me news of my dear Robert?
Yes, I saw him yesterday and he spoke of you. His delight at having your portrait was touching. I feel that his fine, tranquil bearing gives much hope for his recovery, dear lady.
Meanwhile, I must do all I can to let the world hear Robert's music.
Are you playing many of his pieces in England?
Yes, and some of Beethoven's and Mendelssohn's too. I hope someday to play something of yours, Johannes.
Mademoiselle Lynn, madame.
Good evening, Miss Lynn.
Good evening, Madame Schumann.
How delighted I am to see you. May I introduce to you my good friend, Herr Brahms?
Good evening, mademoiselle.
I came for permission to sing one of Herr Schumann's songs at my next concert in London.
Why, certainly. Would you like to look over one of his more recent numbers?
Well, very much.
There you are.
Thank you.
Please be seated.
So you're both going to delight the English people with the music of Herr Schumann. My congratulations to both of you, madame. I understand you are much talked of in London, Mademoiselle Lynn. The papers say that Queen Victoria is to attend your concert.
Yes, it is so. But I am far from having my head turned by the world and its splendor. Herrings and potatoes and a plain wooden spoon. These would make me leap like a child for joy.
I too feel most at home in a household of plain and modest folk. But please be seated, Johannes. The children have a surprise for you, and I am sure that Lynn will not object.
Listen.
Miss Lynn, may I introduce to you the children? Marie, Elise, Julie, Felix, and Ludwig.
Oh, my fine fellow. What do you take me for? An elephant or a kangaroo?
Now, children, let us show Uncle Brahms what we can do with the songs he has written for us. And we will do some of Papa's scenes from childhood, too. See the inscription in both of these books. To my little friends, Marie, Elise, Julie, Felix, and Ludwig. Now, Marie, will you please begin?
Shall I play important event?
That will be fine.
Pretty little chick, Mickey, Mickey, Mick. Where, oh, where is my pretty little chick?
Oh, there is dirty but Mickey. Cock-a-doodle girls, my chickie.
Where, oh, where is my pretty little chick? Mickey, Mickey, Mick. Where, oh, where is my pretty little chick? There, oh, there is my pretty little chick. Mickey, Mickey, Mick. There, oh, there is my pretty little chick.
I wish you were there.
pretty little chick. Mickey, Mickey, Mick. There, oh, there is my pretty little chick.
Shall we all sing the Barefoot Bass?
Sweet lass, why trippest thou barefoot around? Thou'lt hurt thy pretty white feet on the ground. La 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 la, la 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 la, thou'lt hurt thy pretty white feet on the ground.
There's a barefoot bass and for I have
the air
holes
in
my shoe.
La 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 la. Young rascals, off to bed. Yes, yes, they're there. Four lumps to the one that gets to sleep first. I'll be up in 5 minutes to see you.
Can we get a potato salad tomorrow, Uncle Brahms? And a pretzel?
Yes, yes, off to bed with you.
Hey,
ma'am.
The children asked me to give you this box of sweets, but I told them you wouldn't be seeing them again tonight. I hope it was all right to do so.
Yes, Bertha. That was thoughtful of you. It is best that I leave them with happy thoughts of me. Here is my English address in England, my address in England, Bertha. And please don't lose it.
The carriage is here, ma'am.
Thank you, Bertha.
Don't worry, madame. These months will soon pass. Yours is a great mission, so have courage. You will always be in our thoughts and our prayers.
Thank you, Johannes. I can go in peace knowing you are here with the children. You know, I feel this is my service to Robert. As he is no longer able to give the world his beautiful music, it is my privilege and my duty to do so. Goodbye, Johannes.
Thank you.